Okay, the video today is about how to embed an MP3 player to play audio files in your Moodle course. Why would you want to embed an MP3 player? Well, the reason is because if you don't have a player, when you put audio files into your Moodle page, the user has to download the file, which is a bandwidth issue and just not that convenient for other reasons. So what we're going to do is we're going to embed a player. Now this site is called Digital Inspiration. It's a great site. Check it out. All right, so here's the Google Reader player. Here's a Yahoo player. The player I like is this Odeo player. I don't know why. Maybe just like the way it looks. All right, so all I have to do is copy this code here. Now I'm going to go into my Moodle course and I'm going to compose a web page, and I'm going to put here embed an audio player. So I go down here to my compose a web page area. Now I have to change to HTML view. As you know, in Moodle, if you want to insert something or embed something, you often change to HTML. So now I'm going to paste the code in. Alright, so here's the basic code for the player. The only thing I have to change is this area right here between the equal sign and the quotation. So I'm going to show you how I do it. It's kind of like cheating, but easy to do. Now, before I can actually do this, so here's the player. I have to have actually uploaded an MP3 file into my Moodle course. Alright, so I've already uploaded a file. I'm going to show you how I get the link to the file, and I'm sure there's a better way of doing it, but this is how I do it. I just write a little text. You got to do that, step one. Go to this link button. Now I'm going to browse for the file in my file manager. So here's an MP3 file. I'm going to click on it. Now what happens when I do that is I get the URL or the address for the file. So I'm going to highlight that and copy it. Okay, so now I don't even need this anymore. Alright, so let me go back down here, go back into the code view. I'm going to very carefully highlight this text. Make sure I leave the equal sign and the quotation. Now I'm going to paste that code I just got in here. Alright, so let's save and display. Here I am back in my player. All I have to do is click this button and it plays my audio file. See, how easy is that? Give it a try.